It's time for the Clear Lake UCC News with Rick O'Shea and Rhoda Campbell.
Good evening. I'm Rick O'Shea.
And I'm Rhoda Campbell. Thank you for tuning in to News Channel 9, your most reliable source for up-to-date news. Here's a look at today's top stories. An absent Rudolph has been found and is back at his post. He apologizes for his unfairy tale-like conduct and blames the entire incident on it being peak rut season. Dancer, Prancer, and Vixen have refused to comment.
Christmas is in full swing. Santa's in his sleigh. His list is with him. He's already checked it twice, and it's been reported that he doesn't often make last-minute changes. It also has unfortunately been cited that the Kentucky Coal Corporation has for the first time been sold out of coal.
I want a rhinoceros for Christmas? Well, that's what this disappointed child received when the elves mistook the large rhino for a hippopotamus.
I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. Only a hippopotamus will do. No crocodile, no rhinoceros. I said no rhinoceros.
An unfortunate mistake. The North Pole has apologized and was promising a hippo when the parents insisted on a monetary settlement instead.
In other news, Greensleeves is suing What Child Is This for copyright infringement of its familiar tune.
And earlier today, the North Pole issued an official statement after the jury decided in favor of the Tooth Fairy. This year, along with all future years, Santa is no longer authorized to gift any child their two front teeth.
This just in, the Herald Angels have caught laryngitis. The question remains, who will be harking? More on this breaking story as we get updates.
Stay with us for more top stories, weather updates, and you'll never guess who we saw kissing Santa Claus. More after this, more on this after our commercial break.
Are we reporting the good news?
Well, I thought the verdict was good. I mean, Santa's not a dentist, and I don't want somebody messing with my kids' teeth that haven't been to dental school.
No, I mean, the good news, Jesus being born, and all that.
What do you mean? I don't have any notes on that.
It just seems wrong to talk about Christmas and not about Christ.
Do you have the notes? We're on in 10 seconds. What are we supposed to say?
You know what? Let's just go live.
Sounds good.
Thank you for joining us once again. We're going to take you to a local church in Clear Lake, Wisconsin.
Live from United Covenant Church, it's Friday night.
Before we give out our first door prize of the night, we here at UCC Broadcasting need to take a break for a commercial. Did your grandma get run over by a reindeer coming home from your place Christmas Eve? Compensation. Call my law firm today. Dewey, Cheatham & Howe. We'll get the money you deserve. One call. It's all it takes. We're going to fight for you.
You sled chaser.
Call today. BR549. BR549. We'll work hard for you. End of the commercial. Welcome, everyone, to the 2021 Christmas Dessert Theater. I understand that this is the ninth year that we have done this. I am Carrie Eastfold. This is my wife, Bonnie. We've been the MCs for just about all of these. And with that said, you came anyway. So thank you very much for that. Two door prizes. All right. I hope you signed up because we're going to start off. You want to grab the...
I'll grab the door prize.
All right. All right. And I hope the last name it starts is just the letter C. Yeah. You like my job? It's Evan. Is there an Evan?
Evan, I'm going to have to talk to you.
You go to Clear Lake?
Yeah, see, I thought so.
I thought so. All right. Well, in about a month's time, the Christmas season will be over. We put away the decorations, we take down the Christmas trees, and some of us move on to New Year's resolutions. But what if Christmas was not just a season of the year, but a witness that can last all year long? So let's watch as Eddie contemplates this very idea in this first skit, Let Your Light Shine.
All right, man, we got all the lights from the back. You want to get started on the front now?
Oh, sure, that'd be great. Oh, and thanks for helping me out, man. If I didn't have you to help me out, I don't know who I'd get to go up on my roof. Yeah, I really appreciate it.
No problem.
All right, well, I'm going to start taking this down, okay?
All right. That the house you were talking about, the neighbors across the street?
Oh, yeah, that's the house, all right.
And they leave their lights up all year long?
They leave those lights up all year long.
Get out.
Can't. Wish I could.
And so, why all year?
Well, you see, they switch the bulbs out according to the different holidays throughout the year.
You're kidding.
Do you see a smile on this face? I am not kidding.
Wow. So, like, 4th of July.
Yeah, those bulbs, they turn red, white, and blue.
Thanksgiving?
Harvest colors.
Halloween?
Black and orange.
Memorial Day?
Get this, camouflage.
Get out!
I can't. I wish I could.
Wow, that's got to be so embarrassing for the neighborhood.
Oh, it's horrible. I mean, people are always talking about them. And you know what? This is the worst part. When there isn't a holiday, they switch those bulbs out for red hot chili pepper lights.
Red hot chili pepper lights?
Red hot chili pepper lights.
Give me one good reason why I should celebrate the pepper.
Can't. I wish I could.
I don't even want to know what they do for Valentine's Day.
No, you don't. But I will tell you this, those lights are on year round.
Yeah, your neighbors are kind of like the Motel 6.
I hadn't thought about that. Yeah, Oh, and get this. My wife, she thinks we should copy them. She's always like, oh, just leave them on a little longer. You know, like, they're so pretty. Be like them. Get in the holiday spirit. I'm like, no. When the Christmas season is over, it's over. You box it up and you put it away. You know what I mean.
Yeah, you could be like the neighbors down the street. You know, the ones that leave the lights on up all year, but only turn them on post-Thanksgiving.
You mean like the Thayer house?
Yeah, they're the ones.
I've always thought that was so tacky.
You know, I guess these really aren't all that bad. I mean, maybe your wife has
a point. Wait a second. Are you siding with the enemy?
No.
Listen here. I am putting my foot down, and I am not changing my mind, okay?
Hey, all right. You want my help or what?
Of course I do. I'm sorry.
All right. I'm going to go grab my gloves. I'll be right back.
I don't know. I mean, why would I leave them on any longer than the Christmas season? I mean, isn't that good enough? I mean, I decorate the house to the nines. I even put up a manger scene. I mean, surely that's got to be enough. Well, actually, you know, why would that be enough? You know, if I compare my house to what's going on inside my heart, you know, it's pretty similar. You know, I only bring Jesus out when it's convenient for me, but so many times, you know, my heart's pretty dark. That's not right. You know, maybe that's what my wife has been telling me, why she's been trying to get me to leave the lights on. Oh, she is so sneaky. You know what, though? I think she's right. I need to let Jesus take control of my whole life. I need to give him everything, not just the good times, but also the bad. And you know what? I'm going to do that right now. And as my commitment, as an outward sign of my inward change, can't believe I'm going to say this, but I am going to leave my lights on all year long. And what's even worse than that is I'm standing in my yard talking to myself. This is just great.
Hey, got my gloves. You ready to finish this up?
Actually, about that, I'm going to leave them on.
You're going to leave them on?
Yeah, and actually, I'm going to need some help putting these back on the back of the house, too.
Wait, you're going to leave the lights up?
Yeah.
For how long?
Oh, I don't know, just a little all year.
All year?
All year.
You're going to leave your lights on all year long?
Yeah.
You know, you're going to be the laughingstock in the neighborhood. I mean, people are going to ridicule you, they'll talk behind your back, and you're going to end up like the next one of that guy.
I know.
So, why the change of heart?
Well, that's just it, man. I mean, it is a heart thing. And if I don't make a change right now, I'm going to be just like this decorated shell with nothing of substance on the inside. I'm just caring about what people think instead of what's really important.
Wait, are we still talking about the lights?
Yeah.
All right, I got my gloves. I'm ready to work. Let's box the rest of these lights up, and we'll do it all again next year.
Can't. Wish I could.
This is the story of two brothers. The brothers Marley. This year, like all other years, they gathered to celebrate Christmas. One brother loved the Christmas season. And the other brother? Well, he loved the things that Christmas could bring. As the night wore on, the mountain of gifts seemed never to shrink. But As the fire grew dim and the cocoa ran dry, there remained but one gift left to give. This gift, however, was different than all the other gifts given that night. For this gift was given from the heart. So, take a lesson from the brothers Marley. While 'tis better to give than to receive, 'tis truly better to have a giving heart than to give anything at all.
That was funny, right?
Wow, don't you just love Christmas lights? I just love Christmas lights. So those lights that are on all year long, it's just so cool. Now, did you ever wonder what kind of lights did Noah have on the ark?
Lights on the ark?
Yeah.
Warning lights?
Well, just lights.
Flashing lights? You know? Any guesses? Oh!
Floodlights. All right. Good job.
How do you know our script? Say, speaking of Noah, smarty pants out there, did you know that there was an animal on the ark that Noah didn't really trust?
Like, you know, God's the one that directed all those animals to the ark, so I don't get this.
The answer is the cheetah.
Okay. On with the show. Our next skit, performed by some of our talented youth, is a humorous look at a hodgepodge come-to-life nativity set that's been freshly unpacked from their boxes. Here is Nativity.
It must be Christmas again.
Oh, man, let's just be glad we're out of that box.
We could all do with a good vacuuming.
Don't even joke about that. I've lost 3 sheep that way.
Oh, you got some,
Oh, you can't get rid of that stuff.
All right, quit shoving. You've got an injured man here. I don't believe this. What's wrong with you? They broke me.
Not again.
Join the club.
Well... You don't have to complain so loudly about it. Well, I'm as human as the next ornament.
That doesn't even make sense.
Well, who's the wise man here?
Hey, listen, guys. The set may not be as complete as when it was new, and a few of us have been dropped or stepped on or vacuumed up over the years, but we all have to make certain sacrifices in the name of Christmas, despite any oversights or minor inadequacies that the humans might subject us to.
Minor inadequacies? Take a look at this. Does this look like a sheep to anyone else? Because I have only been a shepherd for 18 years, so I cannot tell a sheep from some wool and some twine.
I think someone's got a few sheep loose in the top paddock, if you know what I mean.
You think that's bad? Look at what I have to deal with. Marines!
Frankincense and myrrh reporting as ordered, sir.
They've got to be kidding.
What happened to the other wise men?
They buy it at the Bell of Clementine, ma'am.
Clementine?
Golden Retriever, ma'am. It wasn't a pretty sight.
So you're the wise men replacements?
Yes.
Affirmative, sir.
All right, well, then you can stand right there, and you stand over next to him and try to look inconspicuous. Heads up!
Oh.
All right, let's see. Wise men times three. Mary, Joseph, that's me. Shepherd, angel, barn animals. Aren't we forgetting someone here?
Nope.
Don't think so.
Well, this mule looks like a polar bear.
At least there's no Lego this year.
I'm surprised Ken and Barbie haven't joined the party.
Speaking of weird ornaments, what do you make of him?
Oh yeah, I can see it. A 300-pound guy in a red fur coat scooting around the Judean desert in a sleigh with no wheels. I think that's gonna happen.
They're really reaching with this one.
Yeah.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer? What's a reindeer?
Maybe this is one.
You know, I hardly even recognize Christmas anymore.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We three kings of Orient are bearing
angels we have heard on high.
Stop it!
Mary, did you know?
Not you two.
What?
Oh, this is intolerable.
I won't stand for it.
How can we celebrate Christmas without Jesus?
That's it. I have been fed to hamsters. I spent 6 months behind the stereo cabinet, and 2 years ago, they dressed me up in a tutu. But this year, they've gone too far. No Jesus, no Christmas. Everyone back in the box.
Let's go, sheep. Come on. You too, polar bear.
I've never been so outraged in my life.
It's all right. We're leaving.
Marines, we're taking the gold with us.
Aye, sir.
Unbelievable. How can we celebrate Christmas and forget about Jesus? I don't think this happens anywhere else.
Probably not.
Just my luck.
You haven't seen a star anywhere around here, have you?
La 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 la. Westward leading still proceeds.
Stop.
It's part of the program.
It is?
It's a Christmas carol.
Well, what kind of a carol is that?
You don't recognize that song?
Sacred song?
Yes. We three kings of Orient.
All right, let's hand out some prizes. Would you like to do that next?
Okay.
Door prizes?
Okay.
Yes. I told someone she was singing tonight. All right. Here we go. Why don't you grab this?
Okie doke. How about another one?
Okay.
That's kind of heavy.
All right. Lord, give me one I can read. This time. Okay. We have the name of Anna Williamson. Anna, there she is, right in the second row, right over here. Some just, you know, throw them in. Some fold them kind of goofy to increase your chances. And look, it worked. I pulled that one. Chris Munson. Whoa. All right. You guys enjoying yourself tonight? Good. Things didn't go as planned when a local church presents its annual live nativity. But in the midst of the chaos, we are reminded that God invited imperfect people to the very first nativity. And he continues to use flawed people to do his work here on earth today. In our final skit, this is called the Live Nativity. Thank you.
And unfreeze. Nice job, everyone. Go ahead and shake it out.
It's like 1,000 degrees out here. No thanks to global warming.
We've already talked about this. Global warming and hot flashes are two different things.
I'm starving. Can we please take a snack break already?
You ate a whole bag of cheese puffs 15 minutes ago.
And?
Look, Marty, come on. We've been at this day in and day out for a week. I mean, we're all exhausted, and this isn't even really a live nativity. We have stuffed animals.
I know, but we make do with what we got, right? Now, come on, everybody. This is the last night of our live nativity, and we've been entrusted with the esteemed honor...
Esteemed honor of carrying on the 103-year-old tradition for the oldest church in Corncatcher County. We get it, Marty. We got your little pep talk 10 pep talks ago.
Amen to that. Can anyone even see me back here?
And you know, I have hay fever, Marty. And you know what activates hay fever? Hay!
I know. Sorry. Look, Bob, I looked everywhere for hypoallergenic hay. The guys at the feed store just laughed at me. What is this stuff? Hey, we make do with what we got. All right. Now, oh, freeze! And unfreeze.
Oh, man, I am literally sweating through my sackcloth.
Why am I in the back anyway? Did I mention I was a stand-in for Touched by an Angel?
I would have heaven from Touched by an Angel any day, sister.
Clearly, neither of you have ever seen an episode of Charlie's Angels.
Not the same, Bob. Not even close.
I'm sensing an undertone of hazelnut. No, wait. Yep, definitely hazelnut.
I think it's plastic.
Hey, no one puts angel in a corner.
Oh, wait. Freeze! Unfreeze.
Come on, Marty. We didn't sign up for this.
Actually, you did. All of you literally were in Sign Up Central, and you signed up for this.
No, no. My wife... She signed me up for this. I did not. I am done.
I signed up to play Mary.
And nobody's going to believe that.
Yeah. What about making do with what we've got, Marty? You know, it's hard for people like Bonnie Eastbold and me to get work.
Come on, Cass. These Applebee's coupons aren't going to use themselves.
I want my baby back, baby back, baby back, baby back, baby back, baby back, baby back.
Come on, hey, that's not even the same restaurant.
Hey,
let's be professionals here.
That was beautiful.
Come on.
You're just a diva. Come on.
It's okay. They weren't actually going to leave you. Just look at you. So tiny and peaceful, perfect. A lot like baby Jesus. He deserved a lot better, too. But this was God's plan. He gave him a mommy to love him. He sent shepherds to tell everyone. He sent wise men with gifts to adore him. He even gave him an earthly father to take care of him. A bunch of imperfect people, that's for sure. But God always makes do with what he's got. And this perfect little baby was going to show us what real love looked like. A love that was going to cost him everything. I just adore him.
Who said this? Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son and will call him Emmanuel. God is with you. Do you recall who said that?
I know. That's written in the living book of life, the book that our God, our Lord, gave us. And that is written by Isaiah, and you can find it in Isaiah 7:14.
have, if our shoppers came back with their bags,
three more
door prizes. We'll start with one. The girls that walked across in front of the live nativity used them for props. But they're really, there they are. I said you were going to bring them back. All right, I've got the name of, Margaret Peterson. Well, she's part of the choir. We'll get it to you later, Margaret. I didn't know that we could enter. I was told we could not enter. All right. Joanna Antitucci? Is that close? Really? Anna Antitucci? How do you say that? Antonucci. Joanna Antonucci. Oh. Okay. And the final one drawn tonight is Craig Erickson. There's Craig right there. Okay, we got a little question for you here. Does anyone know what the first toy was that was advertised on TV? Any idea? This is real now. We're not kidding around here. First toy advertised on TV. Any ideas? Got a guess? They did it again. Pretend like I didn't hear that. Mr. Potato Head. I bet you don't know the year. Come on. 1952. Mm-hmm. 1952, that's a special year, right, Bonnie?
Don't know. That advertisement was in April of 1952. Not born yet.
Just a few months later. Here's something interesting about Mr. Potato Head. There was a panel of women, this was much years later, that were discussing what the perfect man would be, a perfect 10. And this panel of women, after many hours of discussion, they chose Mr. Potato Head. Gave four reasons. He's tan. He's cute, in a way. He knows the importance of accessorizing. And if he even looks at another woman, they can rearrange his face. Right? We'd like to thank you for attending tonight, our Christmas dessert theater. It's been a gift from us to you, and we appreciate very much the big turnout tonight. It's free, but we also, downstairs, will have a free will offering if you are so inclined. There will be baskets downstairs by the beverages. And the money that we would get tonight, we will give it to the Clear Lake Area Food Shelves and the Clear Lake Christmas for Children program. And now we will welcome up our choir for two more songs this evening. Thank you.
About Jesus. And the good news is that even though we are all sinners and have fallen short of God's glory, none of us is worthy of heaven. We've all made our mistakes. We've all sinned. But you know what? God still loves us. And if there's one thing I want you to remember as you leave this place, that God loves you. And he loves you so much that he sent his own son, Lord Jesus Christ, into this world as a little baby. And we're going to celebrate that in just a couple weeks here at Christmas. And then at Easter, we remember how Jesus went to the cross for us. And when he was on the cross, he was paying for every one of our sins. He paid the price of those sins. He died, and then he rose again. He conquered sin and death. And that, you know, through Jesus, we can have a restored relationship with God. We can have our sins forgiven. And we can be given the most precious gift that there ever is, and that's the gift of eternal life. And that we can be with God forever in heaven. But that's only through Jesus. That's the only way that we can be restored to the Father. And it's called being born again, born of the Spirit. And if that's something that you have never experienced, we all just want to say that is the most wonderful thing in life, and it's the most wonderful thing for all of eternity. So if that's something that you don't know about or haven't experienced, we want you to experience it. And so after we're done here tonight, I'm going to hang out here a little bit. If you have questions about that, you can talk with me about that. Just know that if you don't have a home church, United Covenant Church would love to have you come and join our huge, humongous choir. Or whatever else that we do. You know, we do a lot of fun things here. But another thing is that there's some literature out there on when you go out. If you don't have a Bible, there's some free Bibles. There's some devotionals and so forth, resources for you to take, please do, or take one to give to someone else. Also, if you need a lift downstairs through those doors there, there's a little elevator that somebody can help you go down, and please help us to eat all the desserts. Not all of them. save a couple for us, too. But anyway, it's wonderful, and thank you to all the people that, I'm not going to start mentioning names, but a lot of people worked hard. So thank you to everyone. And I'm going to say a little prayer, and then we're going to sing our final song, and then we can head down. And hopefully you can stay for dessert. That's downstairs. A couple ways to get there through the stairs there, or anyway, you'll find it. Okay, but let's pray together. Thank you, God, for your love for us. Thank you, Jesus, that you came into this world because you love us. You paid for our sins. And that through you, we can be forgiven. We can be given a brand new life, no matter where we're at in life, no matter what we've done. You love us, and you want to save us. And so we celebrate that this Christmas. Thank you, Father. Thank you, God, in Jesus' name. And bless the food and fellowship downstairs, too. Amen. Amen. So we're going to put the lights on, and we're going to sing a Christmas carol together. This is called Joy to the World, the Lord is Come. So I'm going to invite you to stand if you can, where you're at. We're going to sing this together.